some news hot off the presses.
This station has received reports that the two lighthouse keepers from Oxford Point Island Lighthouse have vanished. The lighthouse keepers work...
You have one unheard message. Two more lighthouse keepers headed first unheard message. On their
arrival, they could not find... Hi, baby. I'm stuck at the gate and they won't let me through. When you get back home, can you look for my ticket? I must have left them behind. Have a good look around and let me know. Love you. See you soon.
End of message. To delete this message, click
anywhere. It looks like they were halfway through dinner when something interrupted them. There were no signs of a struggle, and all their belongings were still there, including a journal kept by one of them. The journal states several times that the island was talking to them. The most common theory is that the men have suffered from cabin fever and were perhaps accidentally washed out to sea. Other cases like this have been reported on in the past, but have never been fully resolved. A full investigation has begun into this bizarre case. We'll update you as the story progresses.
Listen up. We've got some news hot off the presses.
This station has received reports that the two lighthouse keepers from Oxford Point Island Lighthouse have vanished. The lighthouse keepers work in three-month shifts. On the shift change, two more lighthouse keepers headed out to the small island to relieve them. Upon their arrival, they could not find the men anywhere. It looks like they were halfway through dinner when something interrupted them. There were no signs of a struggle, and all their belongings were still there, including a journal kept by one of them. The journal states several times that the island was talking to them. The most common theory is that the men have suffered from cabin fever and were perhaps accidentally washed out to sea. Other cases like this have been reported on in the past, but have never been fully resolved. A full investigation has begun into this bizarre case. We'll update you as the story progresses.
Listen up. We've got some news hot off the presses.
This station has received reports that the two lighthouse keepers from Oxford Point Island Lighthouse have vanished. The lighthouse keepers work in three-month shifts. On the shift change, two more lighthouse keepers headed out to the small island to relieve them.
That's
upon their arrival,
box?
They could not find the
what
men
is it?
Anywhere. It
looks wow, like nice rafting skills.
Something interrupted them.
Oh
there were no
God,
signs of a struggle,
puppy.
And all their belongings were still there,
this.
Including a journal
I
kept
her.
By one of them. The
I'm
journal states
Sally.
Several times that the island was talking
okay,
to them.
Okay.
The most common theory is that the men have suffered
now
from cabin fever and were
gift.
Perhaps accidentally washed out to sea.
Look
other
how
cases
clever
like this have been reported
is.
On in the past, but have never been fully resolved.
I'm not sure exactly.
A full
what's
investigation
going on
has
here,
begun into
this
bizarre case.
She can already draw better than I can. She takes after her daddy.
Public access.
A welcome back to Cooking with Massimo. Have you ever come home from work and found yourself stuck to what to have for dinner? Today, I've been asked to cook with ingredients you found around the house. No pancetta, okay? Let's see what we have here. We have the minced meat, we have tomato sauce, we have mushrooms, we got the bread too, and a packet of pre-made pasta. Well,
I got
that's
you a present.
Exciting.
I'm the Black Veil 7.
Oh,
just
look
don't
here.
Me to watch it
almost
with you.
Forgot
I know
the
you
garlic.
Love his hair stuff, but it gives me nightmares.
Okay.
Ghosts, yuck.
Today we're going to make some kind of rolled meat. A meat log, if you will. Let's start the cooking off of the meat. Lightly oil the pan. And set to your stove to medium heat. Now, with the meat, you throw it in, slap it in here. If you like, you can add some salt and the spices. But they gave me a nothing. I'm surprised they even gave me a saucepan. You know what? I'm not cooking with this packet of pasta. It can go straight in the bin. This meat's looking good right now. A timer for the sugo. And some fungus. Stir this around and let it simmer. Now, let's see. Ah, that's right. While it simmers, we gotta prepare our bread. What do we want? Is a nice pocket. And now where we put the meat inside. Oh, ma tu guarda, I forgot the garlic. Oh well, you get the idea. Okay, let's assemble this masterpiece of culinary delight.
Do you, Sarah Angel Adage, take Gary Ryan Powell to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do you part?
I do.
Some kind of rolled meat, a meat log, if you will. Let's start the cooking off of the meat. Lightly oil the pan.
Friday, June 4th, 4:15 p.m.
Oh, now, it's Mike here. I got a message earlier asking about changing the code to your security door. All you need to do is enter the code. Follow the steps I told you on the day I installed it. I wrote the code on the back of my business card. If you have any problems, call me during business hours and I'll be happy to walk you through it. Thanks.
You know what? I'm not cooking with this packet of pasta. It can go straight in the bin. This meat's looking good right now. A timer for the sugo. And some fungus. Stir this around and let it simmer. Now, let's see. Ah, that's right. While it simmers, we gotta prepare our bread. What do we want is a nicer pocket. And now where we put the meat inside. Oh, ma tu guarda, I forgot the garlic. Oh well, you get the idea. Okay, let's assemble this masterpiece of culinary delight.
Can you believe it, Gary?
Here we have it.
It's not just the two of us anymore. Our family's growing. The 12 hour labor totally worth it.
I know you eat it all.
Love at first sight does exist. And this is the second time I've experienced it. I'm so happy, honey.
Public access.
Welcome back to Cooking with Massimo. Have you ever come home?
You're my heart and soul. Love, Sarah.
Today, I've been asked to cook with ingredients you find around the house. No pancetta, okay? Let's see what we have here. We have minced meat. We have tomato sauce. We have mushrooms. We got the bread too. And a packet of pre-made pasta. Well, that's exciting. Oh, look here. Almost forgot the garlic. Okay. Today we're gonna make some kind of rolled meat. A meat log, if you will. Let's start the cooking off of the meat. I'm not cooking with this.
Oh my God, baby, it's perfect. Yes. Yes, I will. I love you, Gary.
Thank you.
Don't be afraid. I'm only going out for 2 hours. If Maggie can't sleep, just read her this book. It works every time. I'll be home before you know it. Dinner's in the oven. Love you. Look how clever. Can you believe it? I got you. Don't be afraid.
Oh my. Do you?
You're my heart and soul. I'm stuck at the gate. You won't let me through. Just the two of us anymore. See you soon.
Thank you.
Listen up. We've got some news hot off the presses.
Tragedy has struck Pleasant Falls. A woman was found murdered in her home. She was brutally stabbed over 10 times. The victim's name was Sarah Powell. Sarah managed to make a call to 911 before she succumbed to her injuries. The primary suspect of this brutal murder is believed to be her husband, Gary Pout. He was found deceased only mere blocks away, slumped over the steering wheel of his car after a fatal collision with a tree. The murder weapon was found in the car with him, leading investigators to speculate that he crashed his car while fleeing the scene of the crime. The couple had a daughter believed to be 19 years of age, but police have been unsuccessful in tracking her down. If anyone knows the location, please contact Pleasant Falls PD immediately. It is also believed that Sarah is a victim to domestic abuse. If you or someone you know is suffering from domestic abuse, get help before it's too late. Listen up. We've got some news hot off the presses. Tragedy has struck Pleasant Falls. A woman was found murdered in her home. She was brutally stabbed over 10 times. The victim's name was Sarah Powell.
June 6, 1999. My hands are shaking as I write this. Maggie's gone. Michael's gone. And Gary's gone too. At least the man I love is. It's just me and the monster living inside Gary. And the beatings are getting worse and I'm running out of excuses. I'm so tired. The lady next door came over yesterday. She must have heard something. She urged me to call the police, but I just can't do it. I love Gary so much. He's never gotten over Michael leaving us, and he blames me. Maybe it is my fault. All he does is drink, locked in that basement day and night reading those weird books. He's so unhinged now.
Down. A woman was found murdered in her home.
Stabbed over 10 times.
Managed to make a call to 911. Had been victim to domestic abuse.
Just me and the monster living in me does his drink.
Maybe it is my fault.
Abandon him.
Gary so much.